Cub V, bitch. Cub V. Told y'all. You gotta listen. You gotta pay attention. When I speak, you listen. Cub V, up 116% from my call this morning. I told y'all to buy 7, maybe 8. I saw good volume coming in the morning, but I stuck to my bids, didn't chase. And now, it's up 116% now, but you got a wide bid spread to ask spread. You got 11 and 14. It's currently at 13. Woo! That's how we do it. Now, I can't day trade this. Otherwise, I would have dumped 14 because it gave me the option. You're probably going to get some people selling here. I'm hoping that they don't. It just has to close over 1. If it closes over 1, that's a break of resistance, and we're going to see a morning push where we can exit. So let's see how it goes. We got 14 minutes left. Please, for the love of Christ, just stay here. Or go up. I mean, that'd be sick. BMXI, yeah. Not doing so hot, but low volume. I'm literally, okay, so there's 167K volume. I bought 60,000 shares. So I literally account for, what is that? Almost 50% of the volume. Like 40% of the volume. So like me buying, that's what I'm telling you with these thin stocks, you know. Now if I have to sell, the reason why I bought so heavy in this is because I'm seeing a 200K bid at 8. I'm in it, let's see. I'm in at 8.8, but the ask is 9.2. So if somebody paints it at the end of the day, I'll be up like $400. Currently, I started the day at 84.30. I'm at 83.80. Now that might sound, why are you so excited about? But the thing is, well, one, I took out $150. Just because sometimes I like to take out a little bit. If I'm up on the day, I'll take out like a little bit and just keep trying to like flush some money into my checking or savings. But I'm excited because remember I told you I had to sell out of a few things this morning, and I was down to, let's see, like 77.50, and now I'm at 83.87. So I just need things to hold here. I need BMXI to get painted up in these next few minutes. It's pretty slow right now, but I think the final 10 minutes are going to be very, very telling about what tomorrow is going to bring. As far as the rest of the market, I think my other two picks were PRCX. What did I tell you? I told you bottom was going to be 13, low of the day, 0.0013. So called that to a T. You got a bid at 14. That's where the price currently is. And you have an ask at 15. So that's going to close up. So if you pick that one and you got in at 13, you're good. PTAM was the other one. PTAM. Let's see where we're at with that. Now that's down 15%. But like I said, the bid, what did I say to bid? 2223. And that's what got sold out today. Only 638,000 volume, which is nothing. Again, that's a load stock. You got to just keep buying that slowly and wait. I'm looking to enter that soon. Probably after I get in out of Cub V, I'll start loading that. Okay, now we got a bid in Cub V at 13. We got the ask at 14. Come on, baby. Just please close above 1. We close above... Oh, they're starting to dump. See, this is the day traders. Still at 13, 116%. We need these day traders to chill. Just chill. I can't sell because, like I said, I'm under the restriction of 20. You have to have 25,000 or above. I started this at a low rate or a low amount in my portfolio because I wanted to show you guys that you don't have to start with 25,000. There's ways to do this. And most people don't have 25,000 to start with. So I figured, you know, 8,000 is a much more relatable number. God, if these people dump, I'm going to be so salt. But it looks like the bid at 13 is a fake bid. 1,000 or 10,000 on the bid, but it's getting slammed and it's not moving. That's called an iceberg order. So a lot of times you'll see it on the ask where it'll say 10,000. And it's usually a signal of dilution if it's on the ask, because an iceberg just basically means you can only see the tip of that. The MMs, which are the market makers, oh God, they're dumping. The MMs, that are the market makers, they're all algorithms now. They used to actually be people. But what they'll do is they'll hide a bunch of shares on the ass. So you think, oh, there's only 10,000 shares there. I'll hit that. And you'll buy 2 million on the ask and it won't do anything. That's the company selling shares most likely. Because, well, they are, just slow down. It's still at 13, but it's like, relax, relax. Let's get this going. Still a lot of time here. It just cannot fall off the wagon. I'm surprised it's even at 13, to be honest with you. I was just expecting to load today. Some days you just want to get in a stock and it doesn't really matter what it does, like BMXI. You know, you're not always going to make money the day you buy something. In fact, most of the time, if you're buying and you're immediately making money, that means you're buying into a pump, and that's very risky. Again, if you can't day trade, you might be in trouble. All right, so I'm not just going to stare at this and bore you guys. Let's see what else is happening around the market. Let's go to IHUB. Let's see what else is popping. Geggy, this is one I like. G-E-G-I. It's getting dumped hard. Yes. That's a good thing because we're not in it. We're looking at, in Geggy, let's write this down again, and we're going to set an alert. Geggy. G-E-G-I. I'm finding support here at a little bit over 005, which is almost 50% of what it is now. But you're getting a lot of people selling. This is going to come back down. 0.00. I'll do 55 to be safe. That's where I'll set my alert. So once it hits that price, it'll alert me, and then I could potentially buy in, depending. I mean, I would say that's almost a no-brainer if it comes down there. There's another one. GGII, how's that looking? Wow, they are really, I think they're diluting pretty heavily. You're getting a pretty strong downtrend here, coming from 2 cents. GGII. Right now you're at 0.0031. I mean, this should be finding a bottom around here. I would start to load. If it knocks into the 2s, 2.8, 2.9, might be a good idea to get in. They're going to pump this again, but they are diluting heavy, so I'd be careful. Do a starter. Sometimes you don't want to just go in heavy on your first buy. In fact, none of the time you do. Start with something you're willing to risk. Let's say it's 15. If you have a $10,000 account, you want to risk $1,000 as your starter. If it goes up, great, you make money. If it goes down a little bit, you can keep scaling in. Now that goes against the 10% downside, but it depends on how you're playing it. If that's your strategy and you just have $1,000 in there and it goes down 20%, you're only losing $200, which against your overall portfolio numbers isn't the end of the world. And at least you can track it. So it really depends. I mean, these things, you can go outside the box a little bit, but you know, you have to have a strategy in place. Do not go crazy. Like if you're gonna buy heavy, that's when you do the 10% knockoff at all costs. So GGII is a good one to be watching at the moment. Is there anything I haven't seen? What's RXMD? They're starting to move up the most red. That's probably because they're down a little bit. HVCW. Yeah, I mean, they're dwindling, but it's looking like a good buy. So I would say if you can get in HVCW 0.0009, you're looking at a good chance of making money there. GSFI, what's that doing today? It's got some volume, starting to make a move at the end of the day. It looks like it's creating a W formation, so that's not a bad look. But I'm staying away from that one for the time being. Just nothing really I'm liking there. That's another solar stock. So sometimes it, like, you want to be in stocks that have a trend, but you know, if it's not moving at the current time, it's not the best thing. Wow. NICH. Holy hell. Tanking. tanking, and you would have been buying bottom yesterday. At least it looks like it on the chart. That's why these things are super unpredictable, and you never want to go all in on anything, even if it's trading at bottom, because that thing is down 50%. I don't even know why. Let's see what the boards are saying. The finally qualified chakra. Yeah, it looks like share issuance. Damn, only 886 million shares to go. So they're probably going to reverse split. But yeah, that's ugly. I stay away from NICH. Not loving that one. Let's see if we can find another good one. What's AMC doing? AMC is a clown stock. AMC apes. Get the fuck out of here. That thing's been dwindling. I told my friend to sell that at $30. It's now at $8. Sometimes people just don't listen, though. I mean, as of now, Russian is another good one. Ooh, that's actually creeping up the ladder. Let's see how we're doing on our stocks. Yep, see, I knew they were going to try and close this at 1. I knew they were going to try and close this at 1. But you still have an ask at 13. You're getting day traders out. So this is actually good news. All I want is a close over 1. It's at 66.67%. So you can see how quick these things move. Like I said, if I could have sold today, I would have sold out 14. The bid was strong. I would have got it there. But now we have BMXI moving up a bit. So, you know, I'm only down a little bit in that one. We got 4 minutes to close. If we get a strong close, I'm only up $300 on the day, so nothing really spectacular. But I think the CovV tomorrow, this is going to hit a lot of people's radars. You're going to get a morning push. That's when we exit. I can't do anything about it now. There's nothing I could do. Plus, I wouldn't exit at 1 anyway. It's going to close above that. All right, let's see. We got 3 minutes left. Come on, bitch. Do something. What are they saying? Now, there's also these boards that it's BB Stockhaven is one of them. Where they'll, it's just a bunch of people calling out stocks. Now, don't ever take tips. That's another word of advice. If you see somebody saying, oh, this is like the next big thing, watch it. Don't just buy it off a whim. Even if somebody, one of your friends says to buy something, watch the stock and make sure that like you feel comfortable buying it. If you're just taking tips all the time, you'll lose money. That's a guarantee. But you can see these, Jesus, I mean, GZIC. That's up 260% right now. GZIC. 204%. So again, a lot of times when these things run midday, you're going to get day traders taking profits, especially if it's up 260%. If you're available to sell and you're up over 100%, you don't do it, you're an asshole. But damn, that is a widespread. Literally within the time that I was just talking, because of the size of the share structure, 50%. From 204 to 250% in literally 3 seconds. So you could see, you know, you got to be timing these relatively well. Come on, bitch. You got 1 minute. Would someone just paint the ask? Someone, please, for the love of God, paint these stocks. Painting the ask basically means, oh, my God, BMXI, why are you selling? Come on, someone paint it, please. My God, would someone please paint CubV, please? All you have to do is hit the ask. Yes, they hit it. See, that's what I'm trying to tell you. 116%, we got literally 50 seconds. Not even, 30 seconds. Please. Wait, no way. Wait, how's that possible? Bing bong, both painted. Bro, painted. I tell you, if I had a career, I'd be a fucking painter. Now, I couldn't paint, but somebody else obviously did, and that's huge. Why? Because I just closed my day up $1,400. $1,400 a day keeps the job away, and you could guarantee that. That's beautiful shit right there. That's just fucking beautiful shit. That's fucking beautiful shit. We got... Okay, so, I mean, can I do any better on my first live stream? We got 116.67% income fee. Bing bong. We got BMXI. I mean, all day I had to deal with a red ticker. Closed at 9-1. Bought in at 8-8. Again, sometimes you just have to load throughout the day. It took me about 4 separate buys to get into this bitch. Someone fucking closed it up. I'm loving it. Now, here. I'll show you why I'm excited. I mean, sometimes this shit seems easy, but tomorrow I might be literally hanging myself in that closet behind me. So, like, it's when you get a good game, when you play well, you get excited, but don't let your emotions get the best of you. Don't be like, oh my God, this stock is the next big thing. I'm ready to fucking sell. I'm ready to fucking sell. Let's see what we got. All right. Now, I think I know how to do this a little better. Let me put my screen down a bit. All right, we'll make this big. Now, how can I show you a good chart? Trading view. Again, I don't even know if I know my login here, but let's see if it's an automatic thing. If it is, I can show you. Yeah, of course I'm not logged in. Let's see if I'm able to do it. I don't know any of my logins. I don't know any of my logins. All right, basically what I'll do, fuck this right now. I'm like, I don't know how to, you know, this is a learning process for me. I'm like 90 years old. It took me like 5 weeks just to figure out how to like save something in a folder. It's sad, but whatever. All right, let's make me big here. All right, so to wrap up, I mean, you got Cub V. You can't ask for a better day than this. You got Cub V, called it at 7, closed at 13. BMXI told you to buy between 8 and 9, closed at 9-1. I got in at 8-8. PTAM, I don't know exactly what that closed at. Someone might have painted that as well. No, so that just had no volume. But again, load stock, going to take time. The ones I sold today... to get into these other ones. So you see, okay, again, like I said, I had to take like a $600 loss right off the bat. Why? Because I saw better opportunities. Saw those better opportunities, was willing to take the loss to get into the other opportunities, and it paid off. If I wouldn't have, I'd be sitting at the same price that I sold at HVCW. It's hanging there, it ain't doing shit. And PHOT, which closed at the same thing I sold it to. I cannot believe it. It had 51 million volume. So that is getting loaded at bottom. That is something we're going to want to keep an eye on. It is like, that's something that's time sensitive. And if they close that reverse split, a reverse split basically means it's really like, especially in the OTC, it's such a bad mark. Like, what they're doing is they're reducing the amount of shares outstanding, so it's going to make it a lot thinner. It's not going to be a heavy stock anymore. And it will, let's say if it's a 1 to 100 reverse split and you're trading at a penny, that's going to put it at like a dollar. So the price actually gets higher, but it's going to get a lot thinner, if that makes any sense. I'll have to do a lesson on that one of these days. Once we experience one, or once I find one that's actually going through that, I'll be able to explain it a little bit more. But right now, I got to eat something. I was at the gym for 2 hours because I'm a fucking madman and I don't stop. But good day overall, boys. Good day over fucking all. $1,400. We're in the driver's seat here. We're making money, baby. We're making money. We do this day in and day out. The reason why I made money today is because I was willing to take a loss. I was willing to not hold bags, press the envelope. All day I was kind of in the negative, and I was like, oh God, what's going to happen? I got an end of the day push. Now we're all set for tomorrow. We're in the driver's seat. So let's see what happens. Hopefully you guys listen to me. If you didn't, you're probably some dumb fuck and you probably lost money, whatever else you did. So, again, I'm happy now, but I could be pissed tomorrow. Green is good, baby. Green is fucking good.